Hi, it's Stacy, and welcome to another Stacy Monday Morsel. I hope that you are well and that your week is off to a great start. Anyhow, diving right in. So, tonight, what did I want to talk about? Focusing on the goal. Something that I always notice, and we're all guilty of it, I'm guilty of it, and I try to be very mindful of it, is that we are so determined in what we want, but we're also determined in how we're going to get there. And the thing is that there's no right or wrong way to get to your goal, and there doesn't have to be a definitive path. I mean, true, if you want to be a lawyer, you have to go to college, you got to go to law school. But the thing is, it may not be the college you want to go to or the law school you want to go to, but the end goal is about becoming a lawyer, right? Same thing with being a doctor. And a lot of times when we want something, when things don't go exactly how we planned, and I actually know people that have literally fallen apart because it didn't go exactly as they thought it should go. And the thing is that you're not in charge of God's plan, the universe's plan, Allah's plan, whoever you pray to. You are not in charge of the plan. All your job is to give the goal, to tell them what you want, to put it out into the universe, and not wait for it, but wait for it, to know and believe that you will get there. You know, I think I mentioned last week that, you know, a lot of times you have to look back at your life and realize if certain events hadn't happened, that you wouldn't be in a certain place. And it's the same thing with waiting for your goals. A lot of times we don't realize, you know, even if you've ever seen The Secret, there's a piece where they talk about, if you saw the original Secret, not the new one, because people don't realize there's two versions. Anyway, Esther Hicks is in the first version, and there's something she talks about, how a lot of times things don't come with immediacy because the universe is aligning things for you. And sometimes we're not prepared for what we say we want. You know what I mean? We all want things, but sometimes we aren't prepared to get there, to have the final step, for that big prize that we want. And there are a lot of little steps that you might need to take to getting there. Also, steps that you might not be thinking about. It's easy to say, I want to be a lawyer, got to go to college, got to go to law school, but there could be something else in that lineup. And I'm just using that because it's something everybody can kind of relate to or understand. But no matter what it is you're doing in your life, or what it is you're focusing on or that you want, there's always steps to getting there. And sometimes you don't know what all you need. You don't know every little thing that is required for you to getting there. And I always talk about, I look at my own life, and sure, there's things I want and I'm impatient. I'm not really impatient, I can wait, but I can get discouraged. And I always have to kind of step back and go, okay, but I just learned something. If I hadn't done XYZ, this might have been uncomfortable, but oh my God, look what I got. I got this, I got that, I got that, and I learned this. And I can always do that. So I try not to let myself get too discouraged and understand that sometimes there just may be more I need to do, more that I need to learn to get to where I want to go to. And so kind of the message tonight is, if you find yourself in that place, don't get so caught up in what's not happening that you think should be happening. It's like when you're dating and you're like, well, he hasn't called me. Well, maybe he's busy. Maybe something happened and he had to take care of, but we don't think about all those things. We always go into, we didn't get what we wanted. You know, it's like when you're waiting on somebody and they don't call, be it man, woman, or child, and there are all these things that happen. And I've learned to stop for a moment and go, you know what? I'm not mad. I hope they're okay. I hope that everything's all right. Let's go there first. Because no matter how much I may want you to do something in the moment, I want you to do it, the reality is that something could have happened in your life. Maybe you had a car accident. Maybe you had to deal with a family member. It could be any little thing. And it's my job to not see you and be mad or go in. It's my job to have compassion and understanding. And it's the same thing that we have to give to ourselves. Compassion and understanding and patience. And to be kinder to ourselves when we're not where we think we should be at a certain time. It's good to have goals and it's good to want things, but it's also good to remember that everything happens in its proper time, not necessarily our time. It's great when our time and the universe's time are the same thing, but sometimes that's not what happens. And sometimes our timeline is just not the timeline. And it requires us to be patient with ourselves and not to just give up because we're not moving fast enough. Sometimes there are steps that need to be taken that we may not even see. And our patience is required. So the next time something is not going the way that you want it to go, just remember these words, that the universe moves at its time, not your time. And sometimes there's more information that you need, more lessons to learn, something else that you need to do. Or maybe the person on the other end of what you want isn't ready yet and they need a minute. So don't get frustrated. And know sometimes when we miss out on things, you're better off. There's a whole bunch of things that I could look at in my life that I thought I wanted, and I look back and I didn't get it or the person or whatever, and I think, whew, I dodged that bullet. I'm so happy that didn't happen, or I'm so glad I didn't do that, or I did this instead. This was so much better. Sometimes, and it requires you to be flexible. It's not about letting go of the goal. It's about being flexible in how you get there. Anyway, this is Stacy. Ponder that. Let me know how you feel, what you think. I love hearing from you. Have a good remainder of the week. I will see you soon. Love and blessings. Bye-bye.